I was literally just sitting and working and about to start crying because I just like can't. Like, I don't know what it is, but having a job right now, it like has stopped making any sense to me. I'm just casually backing out right now. This is a tight spot. Literally couldn't even sit there. I was like, what am I doing? Why do I have this job? Like, and not because I hate my job, it's not that. I have the most simple job ever. Like, if you don't know, I do video editing. It's for this creative agency. I've had the job for the past year and a half, I think. I've been like 50% freelance, 50% part-time job for the past maybe 7 months. Anyway, I was just sitting there and I was about to start crying because I'm just like, I don't know what to do. I'm feeling so anxious. I'm feeling anxious about disappointing my boss. I'm feeling anxious about, well, what if I quit? And then suddenly I stopped making money with content creation. And so basically I got in the car and I was like, I'm just gonna drive and I'm gonna spend time with God and I'm gonna pray and we're gonna hopefully see a complete change in the fear I'm experiencing right now. But I'm definitely feeling like, no. I can't be a 100% fully freelance person because it's scaring the crap out of me. But I think I'm gonna quit today. I did it. And now I'm just sitting at Trader Joe's, like kind of freaking out, but also feeling stable, feeling strong. After praying about it, I feel like something that God was speaking to me was that, like, this isn't like a new thing. This is not like me fully going into freelance is not a new thing, and that I've been grinding and like pushing for this for the past 3 years. And on top of that, I've like known for years and years and years that like full-time job, having a boss is not my thing. And honestly, I feel like I've been waiting for this time period in my life to just like happen. And another thing that I felt like he was speaking to me was that everything that I plant like grows, like everything that I've been sowing into and like grinding for like will grow. Now I can totally be really good at all the work that I'm saying yes to, and like I don't have to sacrifice like timeline and deliverables because I'm too stressed and tired from editing my other job. And I can edit for YouTube whenever I want. Chef's kiss, guys. I think this will be very good and I feel really happy that I just did that. Yeah. Thank you for being here to watch this happen live. Crying a little, quitting my job, grocery shopping, just normal Tuesday. Exciting moment, as we do every vlog, our unboxing of the day is this huge box from Aritzia. I'm really excited for this project because my friend, who is a cinematographer/photographer, he is gonna work with me to like make this content super good. And it's gonna be more of like a creative thing versus a like walking around in the iPhone just like snapping pictures. And we're gonna take me as a model and him as a really good cinematographer, and we're gonna make good content. And it's exciting to me because, yeah, me quitting my job and then me getting this partnership is kind of, to me, feels very significant. Like, I'm like, oh, this is what I wanna be doing, and this is what I should be doing, and this is what I can be doing. And I'm excited to just get to fully lean into it. But anyway, we can do an unboxing right now because this is, I picked some good outfits. Ow. Oh my God, do you ever just sit on a pair of scissors? I just did, so I wouldn't recommend that. It really hurt. But basically I'm shooting for Aritzia 4 looks, and some of it is video content, some of it is photo, and I think it will be fun. I think we're gonna go downtown and get some content on film. And then also maybe go to like a random beautiful field somewhere and get some content. Either way, I'm just excited for how this is gonna turn out. Thank you for watching this haul, but this jacket is obviously a fave. She's giving, I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not cold right now. I'm not cold. Good morning. Hope everybody slept well, is sleeping well. I slept well last night. I woke up at 7:50 a.m., which my usual is way too early. My usual is like 6 a.m. Today, I slept in. I feel so alive and free, and today is a great day. I already know and feel it because one, the sun is kind of coming back. I feel like we are exiting the rainy days. And then two, because I quit my job yesterday, I am just feeling good, you know? Wow, I feel incapable of getting anything done right now. This weather is killing me. Los Angeles, if you don't stop raining, I'm gonna lose it. I'm gonna lose my shit. It's not even raining, but look how cloudy it is. It just feels so shady everywhere. Like, it's usually like clear skies all the time. This is tragic. I am so late right now, but wanted to show you guys what I'm wearing to go to this dinner party with my friend. Because I never show you guys what I'm wearing. I never do it. But I'm wearing this vest and this top and this black skirt and these ballet flats so I can never walk in. And I'm late, so gotta go. Bye. Today is my last day of work, and I don't know why I'm nervous like this right now, but I think, I don't know, work has always been such like a noisy thing in my life. It's like a ring ring, time to do this, ring ring, time to do that. It's like filled my space so much that I fear without it, my life will be quite quiet. I don't know if anybody can relate, but I've been sitting here this morning cleaning my room. Sort of, not quite there yet. Cleaning my room because I think a part of my fear about being 100% freelance is that basically I noticed that when I stopped working full-time that it would take so much responsibility for me to feel like a balanced person because there's nothing telling me you need to be here at this time, you need to do this at this time, you only have this much free time. Like when I have too much free time, I just see a lot about myself and it does freak me out, I won't lie. If you've only ever worked, I think it would be a fun thing for you to take like 7 days off. Don't do anything. Don't go anywhere. Stay in your own life and feel what it feels like. Like if you're having a hard time understanding what I'm saying, you should do that because it's truly terrifying. It's kind of like, wait, so like no one is going to like check in on me. It's just a very interesting, beautiful feeling. And so I guess right now, I am in this place of like, I want to enter into this freelance lifestyle so prepared, so safe feeling, and so excited and like full of hope instead of kind of freaking out like, I feel like a child who's just been told like, you don't have to go to school anymore. It's a little bit like, you're free. And it's like, what do I do now? You know? So anyway, I'm cleaning my room because that helps me to feel a little bit less chaotic, and then I also have a lot of things to do today, and I just am feeling a little bit, I'm feeling a little bit like, let's clean our room and then assess how we feel after that, because my bedroom has just felt very dirty lately, like I just have stuff everywhere. Thank you.
about an hour ago, I sent in my last video that I edited for my job, and I'm done. I'm done. My life is now my own, and I no longer have a boss. I am my boss. I'm the boss of somebody. The boss of myself. Oh my gosh. I feel so grateful though. I always feel grateful. You guys know I say it nonstop, but I really am like, wow, this is my life now. I like get to post pictures of myself wearing clothes on the internet and model and make money. That is my job. And then for fun, I get to video edit and I get to be on YouTube and I get to creatively express myself in all the ways that I would like to do without having to get pulled out of that beautiful space by working on other things. And lavender. Imagine getting to stick your arm out of the window and rub a plant and then you instantly have lavender. That's how good life is. In my last video, I shared with you guys in the intro how I wasn't mentally doing so hot and how I spiritually have been getting closer to God and all the things. You know, me dealing with mental stuff, feeling a little bit depressed, a little bit low, and then incorporating God, it's like beautiful. Speaking of gardens, something that is happening within my heart is that, let's talk abstract right now, stay with me. I feel as though basically my heart has been a garden. I believe that all of our hearts are gardens. I believe that we're always growing, we're always taking things out, we're planting new things. Yeah, I just feel like there's so many metaphors, gardens and hearts, right? My heart, my garden, has been really, really vibrant in 90% of the garden. And there's this last 10% that I have completely ignored, completely forgotten to tend to, completely have let things sit over there and afraid to look at them because I'm afraid of what the fruit looks like and I don't want to touch it. I have felt like that in my heart with a few different things, a few different topics, and as I've been getting closer to God again, something that he or she has been like nudging me or tapping me about is like, hey, you see that side of the garden? We can like work on it together if you want. Like, you don't have to like be afraid and you don't have to like not want to touch those things. Like, we can work on it together. And that's been happening over the past 2 months. It's been really, really hard. Beautiful, but hard, because I think one of the outcomes of me kind of ignoring this part of my garden is that it's caused me to feel mentally unstable. You know, in the movie Inside Out, the girl gets really crazy because sadness starts touching all of her memories and the other emotions don't know how to deal with sadness. And so she freaks out. She's like, I don't know how to take care of this girl. I don't want her to feel sadness. I don't want her to feel sadness. Because sadness, what is the point of sadness, you know? And I feel like I myself have been dealing with a lot of sadness that I'm not used to dealing with. I've always kind of shut the door to sad emotions because they feel physically like a lot to me. And it's been really beautiful and nuts how over the past month I've noticed the days that I just kind of allow myself to feel sad, like they are truly like making so much more space in the rest of my heart or the rest of my garden to like feel vibrant and to feel joy. And so yeah, that's been something I've been going through, but it hasn't been easy, I guess. I've been spending a lot more days than I would like to, feeling low and sad and not listening to my favorite songs and not even having the desire to hang out with certain people or to edit my YouTube channel. I've just been very creatively stumped, but I think it's all been for good, and I feel like I'm out of that now, but I just wanted to share that part with you guys. And I don't know, I just encourage you, if you have things that you're like, dude, I know I have this trauma and I know that like life is nudging me to look at the trauma and I don't want to, I just want to tell you, like, processing sadness, processing sad things, grief, mourning, it's all so necessary. It's all for the benefit of, like, our emotional well-being. So, yeah, I've just been going through it, though. I don't like to see myself unhappy. But I think now being freelance, I'm, like, excited to fully press into, like, I am alive and I am a human and I have emotions. I have all of the emotions, the whole spectrum. I'm not just happy all the time. I'm also sometimes lonely, and I'm sometimes all feeling sad, and I'm sometimes feeling frustrated, and I'm sometimes feeling numb. Those are all very real life things, and I'm looking forward to sharing more of those things with you guys. I guess that's my point for sitting down right now.